I'm talking to you from my office here at the Paper Partnership. I'm going to be showing you some new pattern books that we've created this year that hopefully will please your customers very much. I hope you enjoy them, we're really proud of them here. Today I'd like to introduce you to one of our collections that's coming out under the brand that carries my name. And this collection is called Highbrook. This season, we've looked at introducing surface texture to our wall coverings. It adds an extra dimension to the paper. The way it reflects light creates light and shade across the surface of the paper, adding much more interest to the colours. As we go through the book, you'll see we've included contemporary designs, such as this one at the beginning, and more classical designs. But all of them, as usual with Elizabeth Ockford wallpapers, have an interpretation that gives them a contemporary appeal. So, the collection kicks off with Fontwell. I love this design. I love the way it's a harlequin diamond pattern. There's quite a lot of these around in the market, but I felt they all had too hard a geometric appeal. They were very rigid and you could always see the repeat. I've tried to create something where the colour moves in muted tones across the surface of the paper. So in this colourway, you've got strong blues that move softly into a lovely warm burgundy. When I painted it, I used water-based paints and applied lots of textures and sandpaper and things to give this lovely movement. And then again, across the surface of the paper, we've got a bit of added depth. It appears in the book with two companion designs each time you see it. So you have Fontwell and it appears with Bosham Plain and Bosham. Now, Bosham is a very contemporary, tiny little diamond. Having just said I prefer the way, can't see the repeat here, this one has a definite geometric pattern to it. It has a rhythm, rather like a piece of jazz. It's textured as well. The texture through it comes out in the plain, so they work really well together in an interior. You could have an accent wall with the tiny diamond or the larger one, and then the rest of your walls would look very good covered in the plain. Fontwell comes in a range of five colourings, and I've tried to cover fashion tones such as the dark blue and a lovely coral red, plus some of the softer neutrals that are so usable in your interior. The second page shows this gorgeous beige and grey mixture. And, you know, having just said that the neutrals are less fashionable, actually at this time, these greys are very, very popular. They give a very subtle hint of colour to a room whilst also being really calming to live with. There's a smart, neutral Bosham and obviously an off-white plain. Moving through the book, there's a beautiful green. Lovely sort of mixtures of water and leaf colours here. And here again, we've got the aqua tones that you'll have seen in previous Elizabeth Ockford collections. But now we're introducing soft leaf green, much like the countryside around our studios here. A very, very usable biscuit beige. And then lastly, oh, just look at this. Lovely, soft, warm pinks. Wonderful tones for a living room, but also, can you imagine these in a bedroom with cream silks and lovely, fresh, crisp bed linen? It's really pretty colouring. And then there's a soft, very pale pink and grey. The next group in the book has a very, very different feel, both in appearance and to the touch. Don't know if you can hear my hands moving across it. It has a textured surface that not only looks but also feels like sandstone. We've called these three designs all things named after a house very near us here called Knowle. It's a beautiful Jacobean country house, and in it lived Vita Sackville West. So this is called Knowle. This one, the damask, is called Vita. That's a lovely name. I wish my mother had called me that. And this one is called Sackville. So going back to Knowle, it's a block design. This is the colourway where you can see the blocks the most. The others look more like a sort of soft, lovely organic texture on the wall. But I like in this colourway the way we've introduced the blue, the sea blue, with a good warm sandstone. Sackville is a very smart little stripe. It has gold on it and texture in it, which deceives the eye and makes you feel as though the gold stripes are actually all raised. And sitting underneath that gold, there's a tiny little linen texture of the greeny blue. It's the litho, and behind that you can see Vita. Vita is a tracery of a damask, very textural, almost as if it's been painted onto the sandstone walls. There's a direct coordination between Noel and Vita. In this collection, we've added something extra to the lithos. As usual, the litho shows you wonderfully how the wallpaper looks in a room on a large scale, especially with a design such as Vita, where it's quite an open, large textural damask. You have a litho which shows you exactly how that will look on the wall. But alongside it, what we've now added are these little spots of colour. Many of the colours do actually appear in the design itself, such as this little greeny bluey spot at the bottom here and the stony colours. But in addition, I've added some accent colours. Now, these are to help you work out how to decorate your room. Obviously, we don't expect you to put a wallpaper everywhere. If you want to know what colour to paint an alternative wall, or to paint your woodwork, or how to complement even the other two designs, there are some ideas on every litho. Moving through the colourways we're offering in Vita, Sackville and Noel, this neutral is very pretty. It has a hint of warmth and pink to it, which, again, I keep mentioning the words calming, but it is a very calming colourway, and there's this lovely neutral Sackville stripe here, the smart gold over the top. We have some bolder colourways to offer, with a red on stone. This is like squashed berries, that lovely juicy blackcurranty strawberry colour. And again, you can see here the way the accents of colour are working with the design. They're picking out highlights that you could use in the room. We've got the plain Noel, much more of a sort of classical stony colouring, very organic, moving from a pale cream through to a dark beige. A very smart Sackville. This one is a mixture of red, gold and cream. Really, really useful. Then there's a bitter chocolate and stone colour group, and an equally smart black and gold tiny stripe. The next set of designs in the book are a complete contrast. Whereas these are all about surface texture and feeling like aged stone, this one is about glamour. It's called Colton, which I know all of my designs are normally named after things close to us here in Sussex. Colton Fish Acre is a National Trust house actually down in Devon, which is 3 or 4 hours' drive from us here in Sussex. It's where I go regularly to see family. This house is beautiful. Built in the 1920s, it's in the arts and crafts style, and I've named this design Colton after it because it has a fantastic arts and crafts art deco geometry to it. Again, we've put texture into the design here. You can feel it just in this ribbon of a dark stripe that runs through the middle of the tracery of geometric patterns. One of the lines is a metallic gold, and the other line is a colour. In the background, there's an imitation raw silk. The coordinating plane has an additional layer of texture so that when you hang this on the wall, it has fantastic depth and really looks like a fabric. And to complement these two, we've got a lovely stripe called Milne. I didn't want to go for a black background here, I wanted something a bit lighter, so we've got a white background with the black and golds that appear in Colton on the top. And again, using the manufacturing techniques, when you run your hands across the surface of it, it feels as if all of the threads have been woven into the wall covering. I don't know if you know Milne. He's an author, A.A. Milne. He wrote the Winnie the Pooh books, and they were set in a forest really close to our studio in Sussex, Ashdown Forest. So it felt nice to name a stripe after him. He's a very famous celebrity locally. And this colouring is beautiful, with sea blues and greens and golds, and a very, very calm aqua and blue coordinate in Colton, and a really useful off-white plane. A neutral with hints of grey and beige. Really, really good, versatile neutral that. You can use it in a warm room or a cool interior. And lastly, this is what we showed on our stand at the big trade fair this year in Germany. This is like a sort of a terracotta or a warm earthy colour mixed with a smart cool grey. You can see how lovely it looks in the light though, and we've also got some shots of how it looked on the stand for you. The spots here pick out reds and corals and golds that are all in the original designs. We really struggled in the studio. I loved the geometric design, but we just could not get it to fit into the normal width of a wallpaper, 52 centimetres. So we've manufactured it at 68 to really suit the grand flowing scale of this geometric image. Now, the last group of designs in the collection are called Hurst Damask and Hurst Plain. We've got a few bits of Sackville stripe in there which work really well with them. These two designs, I'm just going to fold the litho over. There's the damask, rather lovely. These two designs are printed on a very fibrous base paper. So with the others, we've created the texture by adding inks that add texture. Whereas here, the paper itself makes the light dance across the surface. So this has a mica and a fibrous surface that glistens. In the damask, we've laid over the top of that the damask in a very matte colour. It has little hints of a metallic gold through it. And within the matte colour itself, there's also a dry surface texture. You get a high contrast between matte and sheen in this design, which is wonderful. It's like a sort of proper woven silk damask. We've got a calm grey and off-white colourway here, shown beautifully. I love this interior of a dining room with tall windows and lots of light. And again, you can see there's a spot of accent colour. Why not use a vibrant red in with cool, calm neutrals? Across the page though, you've got a dramatic black and white mixture. Really, really chic. And you can use it with a plain black in the Hurst plane. On the black colourway, you're far more able to see the fibrous surface of the paper and how it makes the colour move and the light dance. We have a cool greyish beige with white over the surface and flecks of gold. Then there is this really luxurious cream where optically you can't see whether it's the damask you're seeing first or the background. It shifts in and out of focus, and that really gives it a feel of being a woven silk fabric to me. It's just gorgeous, luminescent colour, and there's a lovely big bit of the Sackville stripe here for you to see. Lastly, we have a very beautiful shimmering green. Reminds me of the sort of glamorous movie stars of the 20s and 30s and all their lovely crepe de chine dresses. Really soft, beautiful green, and then nice pink hair of the plane. Again, I've given you some accent colours, and you can see in the light though, it's an Italianate damask, but it has a soft flowing movement to it with lots of surface texture. It's broken up nicely to make it easy to live with. At the back of the pattern book, as ever, we have all of the technical information that you might need and illustrations showing you the repeats of the design.